definitely one question comes in JEE main from this chapter, mathematical reasoning. Okay. In the era when the geometry was evolving, I mean, in the era of those huge mathematicians coming up, okay, Aristotle and all were working on geometry, there were a group of traveling teachers which they called sophists. Okay. Now, these guys, they had a reputation of, you know, arguing for any point, and they used some kind of logic to confuse people. For example, he'll say, Laika is my cat, Laika is my mother, so my mother is a cat. Like that. So they should give some weird arguments where they would confuse people. So there were some kind of traveling teachers which we call as the sophists. I mean, I'm just giving you a bit of background, may not be very important for you. So they were traveling teachers who used to give weird arguments to confuse people. Okay. And then Aristotle, who was working on geometry at that time, he started writing a book called Refutation of the Sophists. That book was called Refutation of the Sophists. Okay. Where he started mentioning some kind of reasoning or logic in order to refute the arguments given by these sophists. Okay. So what are we going to study today is basically logic, which is a science of reasoning. Okay. Logic, which is basically a science of reasoning. Okay. So as you know, in geometry, we deal with points and lines and all those concepts that time. In logics, we deal with statements. So first, we need to understand what are statements or what are propositions. Have you done this chapter in school?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you tell me, what is the meaning of a statement, mathematical statement or a proposition?
It's not vague.
It's not vague. What about you, Niyati, Adwaita?
It makes complete sense.
Okay, now there are three things normally we tend to misuse. One is utterance. Utterance is something which is just a verbal expression, which may include nonsense expression. Like, you know, abracadabra, something like this. It doesn't make any sense. Okay. Or let's say like, goodly goodly goo. So something which you say, which doesn't have any meaning to it. Okay, that's one at utterance. Second is a sentence. A sentence is basically those utterance which have a meaning. So utterance with a meaning is a sentence. Okay. So let's say like, you know, I give you eat your lunch. It's a sentence. Or where were you going in the afternoon yesterday? Okay, give me a glass of water. Wishing you best of luck for your practical exams. So these are all sentences. Okay. Now those sentences which can be answered as a true or a false, but not both. That means there should not be any ambiguity whether the given sentence answer is true or a false, then that will become a statement. Okay. To give you some example, 2 plus 2 equals 4 is a statement because you can say true for it. 5 is a rational number. That's also a statement because you can say false for it. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So things where you can conclude, or sentences which you can conclude with a true or a false, but not both, are called statements. Now, if I say, raise your hand, is this a statement?
No.
Why not?
You can't say true for raise your hand. You can only do it.
Yes, absolutely. May God bless you. Is it a sentence? Yes, it is. But is it a statement? No, it is not.
No, sir.
Okay. All roses are white.
Hello?
All roses are white. Is it a statement?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. I will not waste too much time on this. These are something which we have already done in the school. So we represent a statement by a symbol P. P stands for proposition. Okay. And whenever we have to write a statement, we write P colon and then we write that statement. Right. So if I have to say a statement that Venkat is happy, Okay, I'll write it like this. Okay. Then there is something called denial of the statement, or we call as the negation of the statement, which we write as a symbol P preceded with a tilde sign. Okay, so the negative of this statement. So if I say Venkat is happy is a statement P, what is the negation of
Venkat is sad?
Venkat is sad, is not happy, or it is not the case that Venkat is happy. So there are different versions of the same thing. You know, you can write anything in the exam, or it is false that Venkat is happy. All those things can be written for it. Okay. Now, what type of questions can come on negation? There's something called quantifiers. I don't know whether you have done this in school. There are two types of quantifiers which we normally talk about. One is called a universal quantifier, and the other is called an existential quantifier. Okay. What is an universal quantifier? Have you done this?
No, sir.
No? Okay. Sentences which contain all, or every, like that, are sentences which are said to contain universal quantifier. For example, let's say I give a statement, all cats bite. So basically this statement is having a universal quantifier. Okay. All prime numbers are odd. It may not be correct, but I'm using all here to show a universal quantifier. Okay. Whereas statements which contains there exists or some, okay, these are called existential quantifier, right? So I'm sure you would have used this symbol
for all.
Yeah, for all, or there exists. Okay. So these are basically symbols representing universal and existential quantifiers. Now, why is this important is because whenever a sentence begins with universal quantifier, we have to be very careful while negating it. Let me give you a question. Let's say there is a statement which says all roses are white. Okay. What do you think is the negation of the statement?
It's not the case that all roses are white.
Wrong.
There exists some rose that's not white.
Right. Absolutely. So when you have a universal quantifier, remember its negation will start with or will contain an existential quantifier. So you can say there exists a rose which is not white, or you can say it in various ways. Some roses are not white. Yeah, not every rose is white. Yeah, not all roses are white. Are you getting my point? So please note that never say the negation of a statement containing a universal quantifier like all roses are white. Don't say all roses are not white. Okay.
Well, sir.
If you say all roses are not white, it will be marked wrong. Okay?
Why?
All roses are not white. Basically, see, if you are able to show one of the roses which is not white, then you have negated the statement. You don't have to say all the roses are not white. For example, let's say everyone in France speaks French. Okay? So let's say I give you a statement. Everyone in France, let's say I give a statement to you. Everyone in France. What is the negation?
There exists one guy in France who does not speak French.
Correct. Will I say yes. Everyone in France doesn't speak French, or all people in France do not speak French? That will be wrong, right? Because in order to negate this, if I find one person who doesn't speak French, my job is done. Okay?
Yes, sir.
At least one person in France doesn't speak French. At least one person in France
does not speak French. Or there exists a person in France who doesn't speak French. Or some people in France do not speak French. So there are various ways in which you can relate. Is that fine?
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yeah.
Sir, when language is being created, so utterance, statement and sentence was all the same, sir. Were all the same.
When language was being created, there was actually a meaning found out in the utterance. And then it was made a sentence.
So at that time, like for us now, guli guli goo didn't make any sense. But right, that right. time when it was being...
Right. You, for you now, very German will not make sense. Right. But now there's a pattern in which they're speaking it. So for them, it makes sense.
Mm.
But don't worry about it. We are dealing with mathematics.
Okay, sir. Yeah.
In a similar way, if a statement starts with an existential quantifier, okay, then what is the negation of that? It will start with a universal quantifier. For example, let's say there exists a cat which
there is glasses.
Okay. What will be the negation of that?
All cats bite.
All cats bite. Is that fine? So remember one thing. Negation of a universal quantifier should begin with an existential quantifier, and negation of an existential quantifier must contain a universal quantifier. Okay? Let's see
yes.
whether we have a question based on this in our previous JEE exams.
Oy.
Yeah. Let's say I take this question. Question number 5. I read this question. Let S be a non-empty subset of real numbers. Consider the following statement. P says there is a rational number X belonging to the set S such that X is greater than 0. Which of the following statements is the negation of P?
C.
Others, everybody has to participate. It's not like only one person answers. It appears, no, Venkat, that they have given the speaking role to you. Nobody speaks here other than you.
Oh.
One Dheeraj was there, that also he has stopped coming. I don't know why. Really. So Niyati says something else. Venkat, you said C, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What about you, Amla, Vidyota, Advaita? So, bolo, say something.
Meaning I talk a lot, sir.
No. That's fine. Absolutely. You are at your normal behavior. Don't worry.
Oh.
Screen frozen. But mind is working, right? Read the question. Question says, there is a rational number which is greater than 0. It starts with an existential quantifier, isn't it?
Yeah, I think C and D.
That means you have an existential quantifier here. Okay. Then read carefully and tell me which of the options is correct. It says have a universal quantifier.
Tautology. What's tautology?
I'll come to that. Don't worry.
Okay, sir.
Tautology is a statement which is always true for whatever component values that whatever value the component statements have. Anyways, so in this case, can I say A is my answer? If I say X belongs to S, X is less than 0, implies X is not rational. Is this my answer?
Yeah. Oh.
No, I guess.
No, right? Sir.
Okay. This is something else. This is actually a complication. Next, there is a rational number X belonging to S such that X is less than or equal to 0. Now, existential quantifier negation cannot be another existential quantifier. So, B is also wrong. Okay. Now, there is no rational number such that x is less than or equal to 0. Isn't it saying the same thing? So how is the negation of that?
Yeah, this is a... Oh.
There is no rational number such that x is less than or equal to... That means they are saying all rational numbers are greater than 0, right?
Hmm.
Okay, so... Isn't it the same thing?
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Now, every rational number present in S is less than or equal to 0 is a negation of P. So, D is the correct answer.
Oh, yeah.
Niyati gave the right answer. Good, Niyati. Okay. So, this is how you have to deal with this kind of problem. And let me tell you, one problem is definitely correct.